Praise God. We are talking about the evidence. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
And when I was praying about it, I said, God, I want today, let the power start. Let to be. And God said, no, build the foundation. I want you to understand, even if you are coming tomorrow, you must come. You see, as this brother is having Jota, it's a very wonderful thing. The Bible said that as the word of God were going, them that are sick get healed immediately. I pray that today God will heal you spiritually.
Amen.
I want to speak on that evidence, the word evidence. After this 7 days program, you must really have evidence to say, God, indeed, you are God.
Amen.
I want to tell evidence that I begin to look at the word evidence. And I begin to know that evidence means proof. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
And I begin to pray and ask God, what will I teach these people? He told me another thing in time. But the topic still remains proof. Praise God.
Amen.
And he said, I should come and explain more about proof. I want you to understand this. That sometimes you need evidence of God. Not sometimes, every day you need evidence of God. But can I ask you something? Do you really have evidence?
Yes.
Do you really have evidence?
Yes.
So you have evidence of God already.
Yes.
So what you are asking is for more
evidence. Yes.
Because there is number one evidence that we are alive.
Yes.
So any person that is alive has what we call evidence.
Yes.
And because you like that evidence, there are source of evidence. I want to talk about source of evidence. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Source of evidence. There are owner of evidence. There are man, the man you know, that every evidence you need is in his hand. Open with me, Exodus chapter 20, from verse 1 to 6. I want somebody who will stand by reading and reading the Bible, please. I don't want you to be alone on it. Yes, Daddy. 20 from verse 1.
I read in Jesus' name.
Yes.
And God speak all these words, saying,
and the Lord speak and say,
I am the Lord thy God.
I am the Lord your God.
Which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt.
Who brought you out of the land of Egypt?
Out of the house of bondage.
Out of the house of bondage.
Thou shalt have no other gods before me.
Thou shalt have no other God before me.
Thou shalt not make unto thee
any image.
Of any likeness.
Or any likeness.
Of anything.
Of anything.
Is in heaven above.
Heaven above.
Or that is in the earth beneath.
Yes.
Or that is in the water under the earth.
Yes.
5. Thou shalt not bow down thyself.
Thou shalt not bow down yourself to them.
Nor serve them.
Nor serve them.
For I am the Lord thy God.
For I am the Lord your God.
I am a jealous God.
I am a jealousy God.
Visiting iniquity. And the fathers upon the children.
Yes.
Unto the third and the fourth generation.
Yes.
Of them that hate me.
That hate me.
And showing mercy. Unto the thousands of them.
Unto the thousands of them.
That love me.
That love me.
And keep my commandments.
And keep my commandments. Praise God. Are you true?
Six.
Yes. There are evidence here. Number one evidence. I am God that delivered you from the hand of Egypt, from the hands of Pharaoh, and brought you where you are today. There is one thing I demand from you, total worship. You will not have any other God. It's only me you will worship. It's only me you will honor. It's only me you will praise. It's only me you will bow before. In every randication of life, because I have already given you evidence. Today, you see what is happening in Nigeria. A lot of people have gone, and you are here, having your life as an evidence. And what God demands from you now is total respect, total obedience, total honor. Maybe you may not like the way I start today, but when a foundation is laid very well, you can build a harmony story building on top.
Yes.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So one of the key to that evidence you need is honor and love. Because whatever you honor, whatever you love, whatever, whoever you love, is the person you will worship. Am I communicating?
Positive.
Him you honor and love is the person you worship. Love is a strong affection. Love command. Love honor. Love strengthen emotion. Love affect your behavior. Love appreciate. And love keeps the word. And love first in all things. Who you love is who you honor. Honor and love. If you love him, if you love him, if you honor him for evidence of your life, for keeping you alive today, if you love him for who he is, he must be the one as special, as important in your life. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
A lot of people miss God because God has qualities. And the Bible says his eyes is too holy to behold iniquities. You must honor God in all aspects of life. You must honor God in all things, with your soul, with your body, with everything you have. Love reconciled. Love is important, strong. And love is very, very strong. And if you honor any person you honor, is somebody you worship, is somebody you love, is somebody you praise, is somebody you have value for the person. Any person you love is somebody that has qualities that you admire. Quality, moral right. Any person you honor, is somebody you appreciate. I don't know how to explain it. But listen, the moment you begin to honor God, God will begin to prove evidence to you. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Even big men of this world, when you begin to honor them, their body begins to reflect in your body. Am I correct?
Yes.
So there's no need you come, you dance, you come, you dance, you come, you dance. Yes! The day of our Thanksgiving, you can break cow, it doesn't matter. You can do everything, it doesn't matter. That is part of honor, exactly. But there are honor that is very, very important. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
I want you to read Deuteronomy chapter 6, 5, and 9. Deuteronomy chapter 6, 5, and 9.
The book of Deuteronomy chapter 6,
yes,
5 to 9.
Yes.
And I shall love the Lord thy God.
That I shall love the God your God. One, you must love God for everything. I want you to say for everything.
For everything.
Yes.
With all I have.
With all your heart. I want you to shout with all your heart.
With all your heart.
Yes.
With all thy soul.
With all your soul. Number two, with all your soul. Number one is with all your heart. Number two is with all your soul. Number three,
with all thy might.
With all your might. When Bible is talking about might, it's talking about strength. Yes.
And these words which I commanded this day shall be in thy heart.
Come again.
And these words,
and this word,
which I commanded this day,
I commanded this day,
shall be in thy heart.
Shall be in their heart.
And I shall teach them diligently unto thy children.
Unto their children, because it's what you love you pass over.
And shall talk of them when thou sittest in the house.
Yes, that is, hold on. Let me talk about first thing. What did I say that is first thing? What did I say that is first thing? Your heart. I want you to say heart.
The heart.
The Bible says, out of abundance of heart, mouth
speaks.
Let me talk more about heart. Your heart is what controls your emotion. Your heart is what controls your character. And God is telling you, you must love me with all your heart. And the heart is what controls your reaction to certain things. There's no how your body will act without your heart. And your heart is who you are. The Bible says, out of it, out of abundance of heart, what happened? The heart speaketh. And the process of mouth speaking is an actual war. Whatever you want to do, you want to go here and fight, it will settle in your heart. That is why they say, I was provoked. What provoked is that a trigger of heart was touched. Am I communicating?
Yes, sir.
And God demanded that heart. He said, you must honor me, you must worship me, you must love me with your heart. Heart has to do with your thinking, action, speech. What you love, what you impart, what you sacrifice, what you defend, will come through your heart. And the other one he said is your soul. Let me remind you, soul is an entrance point, between flesh, between the heart. Soul is a center point. And he said, you must do what? Love me with your soul. In other words, it's an spirit being. It's a spirit in you. You must love me. Your heart is what reflects to a lot of things. And your soul is what analyzes to who you are. Bible never says when you die, your heart will go to heaven. Have you heard that in my
life?
He said, any soul that sinneth shall die. So your heart is entering point that control your mind, that control your body, that control your soul. Every human being heart is soul is spiritual. I want you to say soul is spiritual.
Soul is spiritual.
And that is where holiness dwells. Holiness is not act. It's not what you can do with your flesh. Holiness is anchored with the Holy Ghost. Listen, righteousness is doing the right thing at right time. Somebody may not be a Christian, but very righteous. Do you understand?
Yes.
You can call it self-righteousness. But when the holiness comes inside of thee, that Jesus changed the plan. And he said, him that looked the woman lustfully have committed the sins. Are you hearing me now?
Yes.
He didn't say, you that fornicate have committed the sin. You have come to the level of holiness where your eye, the Bible says, I have covenant with my eye that I may not sin against God. So it becomes in a situation where you see a girl that is naked, you will not understand that it's a girl. That time you have come to the level of holiness. Am I communicating? But there are people that can come and pray 24 hours. When they see a woman with skirt, when they see a woman with figure eight, their emotions will change. That what they are struggling is with what we call righteousness. You can never have peace. Let me tell you something. There is a day I was with somebody who were chatting, and a lady was standing, and there's money that is coming out of that lady. And we all know, I went by the side, take that money. And mistakenly, we forgot to give the woman the money. And I get to church. As the message was going on, hey, my God, I remember that the person's money is still in my purse. And it was around 9 o'clock. As I was going, I couldn't sleep. As I was going, I couldn't go. It looked as if there's fire burning in me. I have to turn back and go to the lady's house and knock. The lady opened. She said, is it any problem? I said, yes, there is a problem. He said, what is that? I said, there's money I took in your purse. And I just said, let me. He said, well, tomorrow there is market. I said, no, take this money. That is the level of the holiness. To the extent you will be, the Holy Ghost will begin to minister mysteries to you.
Yes, sir.
Am I communicating?
Yes, sir.
And when you get to this holiness, when you get to this level, then your soul will balance. And when your soul balances, it will begin to reflect in your spirit. And your spirit will begin to reflect to your flesh. Listen, now you know, in church you preach, don't wear skirt, don't wear earring, don't, because you are forcing to righteousness. If holiness comes, nobody will tell you what you will wear. Immediately you put it on, you will never sleep, you will never be comfortable. The day I stop wearing baggy, nobody preached to me. I put it on and put one boot that is called grand assault. I put my distance on, I cross it this way. I am about to come out of my house, no way. I get inside again, go round, come out again, no way. What is holding me, I don't know. I open the gate to come out again. don't wear. Immediately I enter, I remove it, remove my crack boots. Immediately I remove it, wear my trousers. Joy. That is a place of holiness. Am I communicating to you? It's not, it doesn't really mean that you are in the church, maybe sitting as choir or sitting as a pastor, but you begin to ask yourself, what level am I? What level am I? When the Holy Ghost comes to you, he said, them that are led by the Spirit of God, they are what? Sons of God. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
And he said, you will worship God with your soul. And another third one is what?
Might.
And in this era, in this level, is where your money doesn't count for you. When you come in terms of God, you can spend anything for gospel. Because you become, it becomes a burden to you. How can this gospel go? What will I do? Good. Any good you see, you will do it. I don't know if you are God. It doesn't necessarily mean that you will be convinced to bring money for harvest. It doesn't necessarily mean that you will be convinced to bring money for building. You become a kingdom builder. You become an agent of God in the land of living. So any, you know, the demonic forces have their kingdom, have their agent. Am I communicating? They have their agent. They are asking their master every day, what can I do to get more people? Listen, the kingdom of God now has become a politics. I want you to say politics.
Politics.
The devil is ready, playing his own draft in order to get a large number and with his agent. And whose agent are you? Whose agent are you? Whose agent are you? So now you are made in the kingdom to become an agent to get people inside the kingdom. And no matter what it takes to get people inside the kingdom, if your money is necessary, is important, you will invest it there. I was talking with somebody last week. I said, by grace of God, that I will not be hungry till I die. It's not just by magic. Are you hearing what I'm saying? I said, but anytime you have money, that anytime you have money, pass 10 million, reach 50 million, the money is not only for you. You are a manager. God has given you to manage. Am I communicating? So that manager, whenever God needs money, he directs to his people, say, no, I have given you something. Somebody who is hungry and want to die, meet you. God, because if I give you 1 million now, you will come here to give testimony. If you come, what will you say? Say, bless God. Hey, praise God. Every person will shout hallelujah. He said, God have done it for me.
Yes.
Who do you say that done it for you?
God.
Who are you? Testimony you are praising is for who?
God.
And that is it. It means God have put in something in your hand to use it to bless, advance his kingdom. Yeah, I want you to test me yourself. I'm not a young friend mistake. So that is why he said, worship me with your mind. Some people worship God very well, but their money cannot worship God. Some people worship God very well, but their beauty will not worship God. Some people worship God very well, but their mouth will not worship God. Some people worship God very well, but their private part will not worship God. When they get to that one, then it's here. Where is your God? That the God will be looking at you. Listen, that what we are talking, I am involved. I want you to tell yourselves I'm involved.
I am involved.
It doesn't happen. It doesn't mean that you are a pastor. It's not a grantee. It doesn't mean.